pictures released by NASA showing an unusual burst of dark smoke towards the base of the Wright solid rocket booster illustrate why the investigation has so far focused on the rocket as the source of the accident. The theory is the intense pressure of the rocket motor at its height, 0.6 seconds after ignition, broke through the seals of a rocket joint, starting the deadly chain of events. But a new report centering on the giant fuel tank highlights a second major line of investigation into what may have caused the rocket to fail. According to the magazine Aviation Week and Space Technology, NASA believes a pinhole leak in the tank holding liquid fuel may have allowed super cold hydrogen or oxygen to escape and spill onto the rocket booster. That could have frozen the seals within the booster's seam joint, preventing them from containing the rocket fuel and allowing the kind of burn through that seems to have destroyed Challenger. The latest engineering photos show the smoke at approximately that point.
And it would appear to me that the cloud, the puff of smoke that we see, may be some of that seal material being expelled from the seam, and that would then be the start of a larger leak.
The influence of sub-freezing temperature before launch has been of concern all along, since the hard rubber O-rings lose their resiliency under certain lowered temperatures. Aviation Week reports that just 90 minutes before liftoff, an ice inspection team using infrared sensors found ultra-cold spots registering 7 degrees and 9 degrees on the right booster, compared to 25 degrees on the left booster. The unusual temperatures were not relayed to mission managers, the magazine says. That's one of the issues examined by the Presidential Commission in 15 hours of investigation over 2 days here in Florida. Chairman William Rogers said the panel talked to officials of NASA and Morton Thiokol, the rocket manufacturer. And the group inspected the joint connecting two segments of the rocket booster. One commissioner, Nobelist Richard Feynman, said the O-ring failure, quote, looks like the most likely cause at this point. But Rogers said they zeroed in on three main areas: the solid rocket boosters, the huge liquid fuel tank, and the cold weather conditions at launch.
The only